Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the Greek disciples of Buddha, Sariputra. We might understand in Buddhist books the most monk in the writing that put his name in to the sutra to form the teaching is Venerable Sariputra. He is the first Greek disciple of the Buddha, have the honor to his name called Most Wise Man. So in two kinds of sutra and commentary mentioned about him in different story. The early scripture, Pali text and Agama have his writing mostly in many sutra, but have one section special called the Sutra of Sariputra. In the Pali, they have a lot of writing there, and in the Chinese Agama, have 10 sutra put his name on it and have his short teaching on it. In the Chinese Buddhism, or so-called Northern Buddhism, from Silk Road come to China, Japan, Korea, and Northern Vietnam, so on, so-called use the Chinese language translated the teaching in Buddhism, talk about sutra mentioned by this Greek disciple Sariputra in many, many commentary and Mahayana sutra. So his story is very different in the teaching there, but of his autobiography about his life, starting from when he joined into the monastic training, he served the Buddhist community. He is very active in Indian society. And when he passed away, all this information, no matter in Chinese translation or in the Pali text translation, it almost have the same thing going on. So that I just draw down a little bit about this research about his life into a humanity form, not talking about his superior power or personality, but talk about he is a wise man. Want to talk about his life as wise, what he can present in Buddhism means he showed his friendship and his partnership or his position in this society is the writing that have very good expression. So impressed me is because of his this kind of relationship in his life is very touching. Maybe it's over saying he is a good man, but a lot of things we can learn by that saying if you want to apply something into your own life, in order you not get into trouble, in order you can have more free mind, this is a good to learn from this wise man. So the first thing I want to say is, he and his teachers, that kind of relationship or friendship. More than 44 years in the sutra, I do research, he with his teacher. And then he passed away before his teacher, means before the Buddha. And the Buddha heard the message bring back from his grand disciple, say that Sariputra already passed away. Buddha give a sermon, really talk about his life and how he honored this great disciple by saying a lot of story about him been recorded in the history. So 44 years, that kind of teacher and student friendship can carry on. This is will surprise me. How long they can stay in that kind of friendship, and a student, how much he can help the teacher. The second is with his partner, means into the Sangha member as a monastic member. So he have very well known and wholesome reputation in this Sangha there. Not much trouble and not much enemy or bad news from this Sangha member in his time, saying that, oh, Sariputra is a bad guy, or he have this kind of that kind of dispassion and bring trouble to here and there, make the condition go worse. Not much saying, only have two cases what I found. It's small case. And then in this case, when they bring it come to the Buddha's know about this story, and the Buddha call him here to ask what's going on there. And then he just keep lion roar, is it? He loudly speaking something in very confident in the teaching, in the knowing of about letting go, and in the knowing about abandon that kind of obstacle. So this is very different from other story, that when we facing to difficulty or rumor, how are we going to deal with it? From here, I can see the personality of Sariputra is easy to say sorry and easy to accept, apologize. A personality in Buddhism that you have very good quality of the mind and body, especially mind liberation, you have the experience about no self, no ego center. If someone really have no ego center, then things will not going to make worse, but you try to pose it back into balance, make things go easy. Because you know that Nidana is all things is conditioned. All things is supported by condition and destruct by condition. You don't make the condition going worse. Sri Putra is not someone that have a lot of time go to secluded. His life is very busy because he brings, in the sutra say, he bring about 250 students come to learn from his teacher, the Buddha. And then carry on this student increasing and increasing of amounts that he need to serve. The Buddha himself have one sentence make me touching in my heart. After the Buddha, after the Sariputra passed away, the Buddha said, "Oh, this great man no longer have any connection with me into the future. He and me were going to Mahabali Nibbana. He go, he gone, and I will going very soon. So the relationship is so tied together with that kind of appreciation. So from now on, I don't have to worry about Sariputra have no place to stay." Oh, a short story about Buddha is worried about him because he worries Sariputra maybe overnight that no hotel to stay. From this sentence, we can know that Sariputra is someone that very open-hearted and very supportive to the community. Even though he forget about how to put himself into easy. So his teacher always thinking about is Sariputra is because of he need to share his room to someone or he give his room to someone and then he stay under the tree overnight. So as a Greek teachers in the old day in Buddhism and the Greek teacher right now in the modern world is different. Yeah, the Greek teacher in the modern world maybe have his own privacy before open up himself to help others. So this is something that I really need to learn too. If one day I lost my room, just let it go. I still have the quality, I have my confidence to serve the world because of no abiding, no attachment is what we as a Buddhist teacher want to teach people. We need to experience it and can be use that kind of quality before we tell people can let go. Here, he is very good friendship with one man called Devadatta. So this Devadatta is the cousin of Buddha. In the life of him, he want to show he have the quality become a leader. So ask the Buddha, "Oh, you are already aging. Let me take your position." the Buddha say, oh, your quality, I'm a little bit skeptical. You need to go better in practice. Then he said, no, I practice ascetic. Means I practice more into the methods of self-modification. So you practice not modification than me, so I will be a better quality. The Buddha said, no, we're going to teach our student, we're going to announce, we need to follow the middle path. Not in that way, so that then Devadatta going to make trouble to the Buddha. And then bring part of the student away from the Buddha. Then Buddha have a little bit worry about this groups of students follow this guy, maybe have the effect, bad effect in the future. Who going to bring back this student? Then have a little bit conversation to Sariputra. Sariputra, before this Devadatta go to trouble, because of him have very diligent into the practice, so that Sariputra keep a lot of good word for this man, very good friendship. Because of the Dhamma, or because of the benefits of sentient being, Sariputra too, with Moggallana going to this man's where he teach, pursue and talk about the Dhamma with this group of people and bring him back to study with the Buddha. So here is something I want to say is, friendship or truth, you have faith in. So you put your emotion connected to the truth or connected to the man. This is a right view we need to build. Who we are going to follow? Are we going to follow the truth or are we going to follow the friendship of human being? When the time comes, we need to make a right decision. One more thing I want to say is, when Sariputra coming to join the order, become a monk, so he separate himself from his family. He have his mother. So Sariputra is come from a very rich and what we call that lawyer family. So his mother is not have any faith or interested in Buddhism. Quite long this separation. When Sariputra sometime I'm going to have food traveler. And in the old day, monastic is not going to make his food. We don't have kitchen, we have only bowl. We carry the bowl and go to bear some food. That's how we spend the time for food, not cooking, and have simple food, easy and content. and we focusing into the learning, into the practice like that. So from time to time, he passed by his mother's house, and his mother always say like this. This man always looking for the food that people abandon, or looking for the food that already have sometimes, we may say overlap. Yeah. He want to become his teacher's assistant and abandon all my family's business and the money what I have. You are the man. Eat. That is how his mother, when provided the food for him, and then always talk little bit in order to and then after the talking, eat. That is how his mother always say, and then Sariputra is keep silent and quickly eat, concentrate and eat. And then after the serving, having his food already, then he back to the monastery, carry on his mission. Until the last day of his life, 7 days more, he already meditate, knowing his life, almost energy of the life already been finished. This life burning very short, left only 7 days. So he tell his teacher, the life of myself almost got, the energy almost finished. I'm thinking about my mama. I need to go back to my house, and then he is the final, the last one. I need to bring him into Buddhism before I gone. Then the Buddha said, oh, this is a good idea. And then say bye-bye to him. Then he bring all his 250 closest disciples back to the village. And in the that story have a lot of going on. Sariputra show his wise, show his superpower, show his magnetism. So they influence his mother, and his mother saw the truth in the night, enter into what we call that spring entra, sotapanna, got the fruit of the truth. Means his eyes really open to the truth. This is a very good relationship between family life. I myself from 20 become a monk right now, 47. No, 57. I still have family members not become Buddhist yet. Every time when I have come back to Malaysia, I don't have family life party with them. They only have family party is because of want to visit me, and then I will like the sermon, bring them over and tell them how to practice, talk a little bit about life, talk a little bit about the experience of my mission, talk a little bit about how to improve the quality of life. I only have that kind of mission with them and no family party. Life, once you have distance from the teacher, you have a lot of things going on. Nobody can predict what is going on unless you have the teaching with you, you have the practice with you, or you have a very good teacher or partner of practice together. Otherwise, no one can predict what's going on after this. Here is something I want to share with you. The first thing I want to say, right now, this modern world, because of still carrying on that kind of worry and fear of aging, illness, and facing to dying. In the Buddhist teacher, we have something called dying care. Means someone that who take care or nursing the one almost unable to recover, need to facing to dying. He very soon going to pass away. So need someone's take care. Especially he needs someone help him, guiding him in the good conditions of mind state before he passed away. So in this, if anyone want to know more about how to take care dying people or very ill people, how to communicate with them, give them a good information, let them become more, you know, calm, more peace, more energetic, or more positive mind state, you need to learn with Sariputra. He is the first one that very connected to the Buddha himself, as a person that have a lot of cast talking about his dying care experience or hospice experience. One thing that still not give the Buddha himself comfort, Buddha himself have little bit blame him in a very soft way, is because of Mahagunda. Mahagunda is a monk that aging very ill, and his practice is Brahma, for Brahma. So in the day of about the very soon going to pass away, Sariputra visit him and have the conversation with him and know him. He is looking for the Brahma state after passing away. Right? Have confidence with that. And Sariputra is happily accept that and say, oh, this is a great, this is a good way to go. And then after passing away, then he back to see the Buddha. The Buddha know he is helping his monastic friend pass away with that kind of acceptance to the Brahma state, the Buddha have little bit feel sorry about this. And he said, why don't you have further teaching to him? And then Sariputra said, oh, I just determined to follow what his understanding and what he wished, so I didn't give further teaching. Then the Buddha kept silent. A Greek teacher and a Greek student, when they are conversation writing down, there is very easy. Not much a strong word or not much emotion there. It just say something there, really easy. This easy thing is what I'm looking for. My word is not easy. My personality is very, very not easy. So learning in Buddhism that need to talk a lot about practice, how to transform practice. Here is another dying care that Sariputra's going to take care, and then that experience we may share a little bit. We have a lay disciple that support Buddhism very well called Anattapindika. So he is an elder lay Buddhist that have very generous and have a lot of property and a lot of money can bring out to help. So he always help someone that need to be helped, and the charity and give a lot of help to the one who is alone. So he is very well known. So have a monastery called Anattapindika Monastery. Is that property is him who donated to Buddhist, especially to the monastic, to stay there, keep practice and teaching. So when he facing the dying, Sariputra come and visit him. And what Sariputra teach him is something like this. Sariputra keep advise him, oh, there have a lot of going on in your mind. I know that conflict. I know that difficulty. What the advice me, I finish and achieve this experience can provide you as a sample. You may need to learn from this. That advice is like this. No attachment to your eye, ear, what we call that, the senses. When these senses are attached, then you will attach the opposed. Hearing the sound, seeing something, become more touching into these senses formation, become more sensitive into this touching or contact. No attachment to contact, then you won't be attachment to clinging. If no attachment to clinging, then you won't attachment to elements or the material element. If no attachment to material attachment, that is no karma force back to your mind. Carry on, then you can observe that is no this life, period. That is no future life period. Then you can experience, detach to the mind, to the eye, ear, tongue, nose, body. Then five skanda will be breaking. After five skanda breaking, all minds clinging will be no condition. This is what he is teaching to a dying care person. After I reading this, I feel so touching, because I'm doing the same too from time to time, talking to ill, very ill people, talking to very aging people, have not much energy. I see their mind is the same. Only the body energy and the body healthy get lost. The mind's energy is not losing, it's become more active. Active in what? Active in touching, contact. Contact to the reality information, contact to the memory information, prediction to the future information. The mind is not going to calm and balance. It's always active, more and more active, until this energy is not longer supported by condition. So Sariputra going to dying care really have very good example to teach in reality. What in reality means right mindfulness, right knowing. Knowing your body, knowing your feeling, knowing back to your mind, don't let it involve too much. Concentrated into the right moment. Don't let the mind involve too much to changing the formation. If we can do that, Sariputra name it very simple. He give the last word in conclusion. We name this renunciation. Renunciation means abandon. See, if we see the defilement burning there, or we see the worry, fear, and a lot of anxiety in your mind there, you need to abandon it, you need to letting go it, or you need to free from it. Really, you need to follow this sutra teaching. Okay, enough. I think a lot of things that I already do a little bit research, only half of it I share today. I hope I still have choice in the future can share a little bit more Sariputra's quality to our assembly. Thank you.